If you're outside in the springtime and happen to spot a large group of honeybees clustered together, don't be alarmed. These bees are just looking for a new home. While a large gathering of honeybees may appear intimidating, they're usually quite gentle and are not looking to sting anyone. This phenomenon called swarming behavior is the bees' natural reaction to crowded conditions. In the spring, when flowers begin to bloom, all that abundant food helps a bee colony's population to rapidly grow. As the hive starts getting crowded, the bees will raise a new queen. Soon, the old queen will leave the hive, along with about two-thirds of her worker bees, to seek a new place to establish a nest. Back inside the old hive, a new queen prepares to take over the nest with the remaining bees and the stored food. Their numbers will soon grow, replacing the bees that left. This swarm of bees that departed from their home will settle down fairly close, clustering together to protect their queen and conserve their energy. If you observe a resting swarm, you might notice that most of the bees remain fairly inactive, while a few appear to be moving excitedly. These are scout bees, experienced flyers who are tasked with finding the swarm a new home. This relatively small number of bees will search the area, looking for a hollow tree or other suitable cavity. They will return to the cluster and report what they have found to the other bees with a series of carefully choreographed dance steps. A scout bee dances in a figure-eight pattern. As she moves through the middle of this dance step, she will rapidly shake her abdomen back and forth before turning again to one side or the other. This dance move is called the waggle run. The direction that this bee is facing during this waggle run indicates to her sisters the direction in which she found a potential home. While the duration of the waggle dance indicates the relative distance to the site being described, if the waggle run is shifted a certain number of degrees to the left or right of a perfect vertical orientation, she's telling her sisters to face the sun and then turn that far to one side or the other to plot their course. Over time, different scouts may find different cavities which they think will make a suitable home. As additional bees observe these dancers, they may also go and investigate the site described. If they also believe it will make a good home, they too will begin dancing when they return to the cluster. As more scout bees report what they find to the swarm, a consensus will begin to emerge, and the bees will reach a decision among themselves. When a particular site has been agreed upon, the entire swarm will take flight again, following the scouts to their selected location, where they will enter and begin building honeycombs to set up their new home. In nature, honeybees prefer to nest inside a hollow tree or other cavity, but sometimes they might take up residence in a hollow space inside a wall of a man-made structure. If this happens, a beekeeper can relocate them to a new hive, but it can become a complicated process to remove an established colony from inside of a wall. If you see a honeybee swarm, there's no need to panic. You can usually find a local beekeeper who will come and collect them and put them into a new hive where they'll be able to thrive. Capturing swarms can be simple or somewhat tricky, depending on where the swarm is resting. If the bee swarm is resting in a tree or bush, sometimes it helps to clip away a few small branches to more easily get to the bees. Most of the bees are holding on to each other, while very few of them are actually holding on to the tree branch. A box or container is placed under the swarm, and the tree branch is given a quick jerk to dislodge the bees. If the queen is captured along with the rest of the bees, they will almost certainly be successful when moved to a new hive. The few bees that are not captured in the box will usually return and regroup and can be captured with another shake. Any that are not collected will likely return to the hive where they originated. Sometimes a swarm may rest in a trickier position, such as this one that landed on a vine-covered fence. With a little patience and ingenuity, they can still be collected. Honeybees are amazing creatures that benefit us in many ways. If you spot a swarm of buzzing bees in your neighborhood, don't be alarmed. Contact a beekeeper right away or call your local cooperative extension office to help you find one. The bees can usually be relocated safely and introduced to a new home. For more information about honeybees or beekeeping, visit the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture online.